Hi everyone. A few months ago I got this brilliant idea to install a second battery in my truck. Right down here, passenger fender. So I can run a 1500 watt inverter. So I found a brand new battery tray on eBay. Now you don't have to go new with these things. You can go used. You can go to a junkyard, pull one out, and of course it's a 3/4 ton Dodge truck. You know, I've only got the half ton, but when I ordered this thing, or when I was cooking up the idea, I was looking for second battery tray for a Dodge Ram 1500. They don't make them because, well, they only had the one battery. And then it dawned on me. Oh, you big dummy. No, you want a 3/4 ton truck part. So when I did that search, I found the part. Anyway, it's really simple to install. There's a dead possum over there. The bolts up here are 8 millimeter, and I bought those at the auto parts store. I could have gotten it from the hardware store. Gravity. Things lost and gone forever. Okay. And I got some fender washers here. Millimeter. Gravity. Alright, now I could leave it like this, but it's a bit flip-floppy, and if I have a battery in it, it could really travel. So I've got a couple of other bolts to put through the bottom. I don't know how I'm going to do that, because those bolts go in right down here, those two holes. And I don't know if I can access those from down here or not. Still be able to tighten them. What I want to do is I want to put these up from the bottom so the head is on the bottom and the threads are up top. So if I want to, I can unbolt it later without breaking the bolt. I don't know if I can get in here enough to do that. So I'm not sure how I'm going to do this. I went and got a bucket so I could stand on it to get me up and over. There we go. This is difficult. More difficult than I figured it would be. Glad I got the 1.5 inch screws. Or bolts, I mean. Of course, I probably just did the easy one first. All right. All right, so I was going along and I realized I forgot the piece I want to use here for my battery hold down. Like I've got over there on my other battery, because the factory piece broke, I don't know, 15, 16 years ago. So I'm going to use quarter inch threaded rod, and I need to put it on the inside here before I put the battery in. Wish I'd have thought of that a few minutes ago, but anyway, at least I didn't get too far. And I got a better idea on how to do this bolt, to do the bolts down here to hold the bottom. Half as long as it is. Okay. Right in there. Cut down this quarter inch threaded rod. I can't find my small bolt cutters. Alright, so I got the threads chased. Funny how a quarter 20, I used a quarter 20 die, but it really ate a bunch of steel out of that. Here's the old part. And then of course the one that I just chased, I mean you just saw me cut it. Just amazing. So I need to check both ends. Make sure that fits there, it does. Make sure it fits here, yes it does, good. Run over there and check my length. Perfect. Okay, so got that out. Flip this over. Washer. Fender washer on the bottom. And we'll run it about there. And there. It's going to be perfect. Oh, the possum stinks. And my neighbor over there has some decent music on. I hear Geddy Lee's voice. So that's a good thing. We're there. Test fit. That sticks up a bit. Okay. That's what I thought. He's listening to moving pictures. Song's about a car. It's nice to have cool neighbors. closer. Actually, what I do is might leave it just like that. I think that'll work. Heck, it'd probably work the other way too. Let's God, that possum stinks. Yeah, I think I'll be all right. No strikes up there. That's a good thing. All right, I can put this thing back in. Beautiful. It's basically in there. I gotta go in, get a drink of water, and I'll come back out. I have to wash my hands because I'm gonna tape these bolts to the underside of the inner fender. Hopefully hold them up there while I run the nuts down on them. All right, well, got my cup of water. Got my hands clean. They had cutting oil on them from when I threaded that rod. So now what I'm going to do is look under here to see how dirty the fender is. I ain't bad at all. Those ought to hold up there real nice. Okay. See if I can do this. Since I know I can get to that one from above if I have to, I'm going to go with the one that I can't reach from up there. Get it held in place. And you see it right there, which is awesome. This. This. And that. Let me reposition. So I might be able to see something here. I don't know. Still gotta work my feel. Alright, toit. Oh yeah, ain't going nowhere. So if we look up here, but you see where the tape twisted a little bit? But not bad. So, repeat the process for number two. That one. That one's now ready to be tightened. Stain washer. Lock washer. Oh, this is infinitely easier. Man. Glad the idea worked. Taping them bolts up there. Of course, if the truck would have been muddy, way dirty under there, it wouldn't have. Come on, and the possum stinks. It stinks so bad you can taste it. Installed. It didn't take that long. I wish I'd remembered to cut that first and put that in first, but that's solid. I'll do the same thing for over here like I got on my other battery. so the next step, before I buy a battery, is I have a battery isolation switch that I'm going to install. Because if I don't, if I just hook up the second battery, bad things could happen. So we got that to do. What else? Battery cable kit. I'm gonna have to buy that for a 3/4 ton diesel as well, because I need a positive lead that is 120 inches long. And the negative one, well, it'll ground somewhere down there, up here, and it doesn't matter. So I'm gonna clean up, put tools up, mow the grass. So if you like the video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, I do appreciate it, and I will see you later.